My name's Jodie Parsons and I'm an educational leader at Sunshine College and in charge of curriculum from 7 to 12. So at Sunshine College, all our maths classes are differentiated from years 7 to 10.
Differentiation plays a really important role in the program here at Sunshine College. We know that if we want our students to work within their zone of proximal development, that the tasks have to be just right for them.
I was working in a Year 7 class alongside another teacher, so not in the same classroom, but we had adjoining classrooms next to Yvonne. And you could see that there was clearly different things happening in our classroom. I had the top end students as such, and Yvonne had a more of a numeracy class. So Yvonne and I decided to join our classrooms up together. So in fact, it really did enhance student learning, but it enhanced our teaching practice as well, because it meant that I could be working with a range of students over a range of abilities, and the same as Yvonne, and it gave us a potential to have much more of a greater professional conversation.
This program came about because of the need to improve our outcomes for students. The precursor to the NAP plan results was the AIM data here in Victoria, and we looked carefully at those and we knew that we needed to address the low outcomes for our students. And I was lucky enough to have two teachers come to me and say they would like to try something new. So I gave them the go ahead to start a new approach.
And what we found really, really worked was the developing lessons based on our students. So finding out really what our students were capable of and finding out that range of students in our classrooms and then designing lessons around those. Once we have developed enough curriculum to meet all our students' needs and all our classrooms' needs, we actually removed the textbook.
We trialled the program with one campus, within one campus, and then we outsourced it to the other campuses. A lot of ongoing refinement to the program over time, and I think you'll find that the program isn't stagnant at the moment, that we are trying to improve it at every opportunity we get.
Today's lesson was about students collecting data as a means of looking at fractions, decimals and percentages. Okay, so today's activity in maths, we're going to look at creating valid surveys. Okay, just like the learning intention states. And then we're going to look at how we can represent that using mathematics. Each differentiated maths lesson at Sunshine College begins with a warm-up. The main intent of the warm-up is for engagement.
Okay, next word, higher or lower than A4.
The differentiated approach is when a teacher will walk into the classroom with one activity but pitched at a minimum of three levels. So they'll have the one learning outcome that all students will be learning towards. However, the activities that teacher takes in there are at a minimum of three different levels, providing all students an opportunity to learn.
To help you decide whether you want to pick a one-star task, a two-star or a three-star, I want you to think about the types of skills that we might be using in that. So if you're beginning to collect data and write a good, valid question, maybe a one-star task is a good option for you. Two-star tasks are for students who are really good with fractions. Okay, starting to understand their fractions quite well. Three-star for students who can convert between fractions, decimals and percentages.
During that time, students will be working in pairs or in threes on a specific learning outcome, and the teachers will walk around the classroom teaching at the point of need.
If you've got to survey 25 people, what happens if 24 people have something different?
Like an option called other?
Brilliant, you could have an option called other.
Students who were doing a three-star task could not collect either a 10, a 20 or a 25 pieces of data because we wanted them to work from numbers that were a little bit more difficult for them. And students who were working on a two-star task needed to collect 25 pieces of data.
Volleyball.
Once they'd collected their data, they filled in their fractions, decimals and percentages table. Students then needed to represent their percentages that they'd collected on that strip graph.
So your 25 centimetre strip, how many pieces do you need to divide it into? Why five? Okay, it does need to have five different options. Are they going to all be the same size?
No.
The question we get asked often is, how do you make sure that students don't pick a task which is too easy for them? And we actually find it's the opposite. Students will often choose a task that's too difficult for them. If at the end of a lesson a student writes a reflection and they might say, well, I've not learnt anything that day, it gives me as a teacher an opportunity to have a discussion with them about the choices that they made at the beginning of the lesson in order to enable them to learn.
So if you've just made a discovery, or just had an idea, I want that to be your reflection.
So at the beginning of each unit, students fill in a student capacity matrix. We also assess our students 4 times a year using the on-demand testing. Over time, we're able to track our student progress using this on-demand data, using our NAPLAN data, and also using this student capacity matrix. Our students are improving at a rate which is greater than expected. When we compare our students to the average Victorian student, our students are improving at a greater rate than they are.